The attachments: anterior superior iliac spine. Lateral end of the inguinal ligament is attached to the upper part of the anterior superior iliac spine. It's lower, below that, it gives origin to a parallel muscle which is known as the sartorius. Sartorius arises from anterior superior iliac spine, passes across the thigh on the medial aspect of the knee joint and gets inserted into the upper medial surface of tibia. Now we come to anterior inferior iliac spine. It gives attachment to the straight head of rectus femoris in the upper part, and the reflected head is below, just above the acetabulum. This is the rectus femoris lying anterior to the vastus intermedius. This is typically bipinnate in nature. The tendon is in between and the fibers are going downwards and medially and laterally to each side. This muscle gets inserted into the upper border of the patella. The anterior inferior iliac spine, in its lower part, it gives attachment to a very strong ligament, the iliofemoral ligament. It is inverted Y-shaped. The apex is attached to the anterior inferior iliac spine, and by its two ends, it is attached to the two parts of anterior intertrochanteric line of femur. Also seen is the pubofemoral ligament going medially and arising from the body of the pubis to the femur. Also in relation to the hip joint is the ischiofemoral ligament from the body of the ischium to the acetabulum. The ventral segment of the iliac crest. The outer lip of the iliac crest gives attachment to the fascia lata in its whole extent. The outer lip of iliac crest also gives origin to tensor fascia lata in front of the tubercle of iliac crest. It gets inserted into the iliotibial tract. This tract extends down till the lateral condyle of tibia. Into this iliotibial tract is also inserted the big gluteus maximus muscle. The whole of upper half and superficial part of lower half, that means almost 3/4 of the muscle, is inserted into the iliotibial tract. The outer lip also gives insertion to external oblique in the anterior 2/3 of outer lip of ventral segment. The intermediate area of the ventral segment of iliac crest gives origin to internal oblique in the anterior 2/3. The inner lip gives origin to transversus abdominis in the anterior 2/3. Even fascia transversalis is attached all along the length. The dorsal segment of iliac crest. From the dorsal lateral slope of the dorsal segment arises the huge anti-gravity muscle, which is the gluteus maximus. It also arises from the posterior most part of the gluteal surface of hip bone and the subjacent muscles. The next figure shows the attachment of the gluteus medius muscle, which arises between the posterior and anterior gluteal lines. The smallest one is the gluteus minimus, which arises between the anterior and inferior gluteal lines. The medial slope of the dorsal segment of iliac crest gives origin to the erector spinae, which is the true muscle of the back, supplied by the dorsal primary rami of the various spinal nerves. This is the iliac fossa, and only iliacus muscle arises from the upper 2/3 of the iliac fossa, and this is the muscle which is flexor of the hip joint. The sacropelvic surface. The iliac tuberosity gives attachment to interosseous sacroiliac ligament, dorsal sacroiliac ligament, posteriorly, and iliolumbar ligament, superiorly. The interosseous sacroiliac ligament is attached to wide, rough area adjoining the concave margins of auricular surface on both the sacrum and the hip bone. Dorsal sacroiliac ligament is attached above the interosseous one on the hip bone. Iliolumbar ligament extends from transverse process of fifth lumbar vertebra to posterior part of inner lip of iliac crest. Ventral sacroiliac ligament is attached to convex margin of auricular surface. It is also attached to pre-auricular sulcus. Arising from the ischial tuberosity is a strong ligament, the sacrotuberous ligament. It passes up to the posterior superior iliac spine, posterior inferior iliac spine, and to the back of the sacrum. Extending between the ischial spine and the lower part of the sacrum is a horizontally placed ligament, the sacrospinous ligament. These two ligaments convert the greater sciatic notch and the lesser sciatic notch into greater sciatic foramen and the lesser sciatic foramen. This specimen shows the ischial tuberosity, and arising from the ischial tuberosity is a strong sacrotuberous ligament going up to the sacrum, the posterior inferior iliac spine, and the posterior superior iliac spine. Extending from the ischial spine is a horizontally placed ligament, the sacrospinous ligament. The sacrotuberous and sacrospinous ligament convert the greater sciatic notch and lesser sciatic notch into greater sciatic foramen, bigger, and a smaller lesser sciatic foramen. Attachments on the pubis, pubic tubercle. There is a medial end of the inguinal ligament is attached. Then ascending loops of cremaster muscle are attached to the pubic tubercle. The pubic tubercle is an important landmark. Inguinal hernia is seen above and medial to the pubic tubercle, whereas the femoral hernia is seen below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. From the pubic crest is the origin of rectus femoris. Medial side is the origin of medial head of rectus femoris, and lateral side is the origin of lateral head of rectus femoris. The anterior surface of body. In the angle between the body and the ramus, there is the tendinous origin of the adductor longus. Gracilis is along the inferior ramus. Adductor brevis is lateral to the gracilis, and obturator externus is around the margin of the obturator foramen. And still below it is the extension of the origin of the adductor magnus muscle. On the pectineal surface is the pectineus muscle. This dissected specimen shows the left half of the pelvis. The inguinal ligament extending from the anterior superior iliac spine to the pubic tubercle that forms anterior superior iliac spine to pubic tubercle. A triangular extension of the inguinal ligament goes downwards to the pectineal line, so that the apex is at the pubic tubercle. One margin is with the inguinal ligament and other margin is with the pectineal ligament. This is known as the lacunar part or the pectineal part of the inguinal ligament. This has important relation to the femoral hernia. Posterior to this lacunar ligament is the attachment of the conjoint tendon, which is formed by fusion of the internal oblique muscle and the transversus abdominis muscle. The obturator groove transmits the obturator nerve accompanying vessels for the adductor muscles of the thigh. The pelvic surface of the pubis is related to the urinary bladder. It is also related to ductus deferens or the round ligament of uterus. Ischial spine gives attachment to sacrospinous ligament. Its dorsal surface is crossed by pudendal nerve medially, internal pudendal artery in between, and nerve to obturator internus laterally. Sacrospinous and sacrotuberous ligaments form greater sciatic foramen above and lesser sciatic foramen below. Upper and lower margins of lesser sciatic notch give origin to superior gemellus and inferior gemellus. Upper and lower margins of the lesser sciatic notch give origin to superior gemellus and inferior gemellus. Ischial tuberosity, the upper area, supralateral part, gives origin to the semimembranosus muscle. The inferomedial part gives origin to semitendinosus and long head of biceps femoris muscle. The lower area, medial part, there is a bursa on which one comfortably sits, and the lateral part gives origin to the ischial head of the adductor magnus muscle. The conjoint ischiopubic rami, the upper border provides attachment to the obturator membrane, lower border gives attachment to fascia lata and colles fascia of perineum. The inner surface is divided into three areas. Upper area, close to obturator foramen, gives attachment to obturator internus muscle. Upper ridge gives attachment to the endopelvic fascia. The middle area is related to deep transversus perinei muscle and also related to dorsal nerve of penis and internal pudendal vessels. The sphincter urethri, as of now, is no more attached to the rami. It is within the wall of urethra. The lower ridge gives attachment to the important perineal membrane, and the lower area is related to superficial transversus perinei muscle. Ischiocavernosus is attached and it covers the crus penis. The acetabulum. Acetabulum is a deep cup-shaped socket directed laterally, downwards and forwards. The margin is deficient inferiorly and is called the acetabular notch. A horseshoe-shaped facet articular surface is seen on the anterior, posterior and superior parts of the acetabulum. The acetabulum labrum, it is a fibrocartilaginous labrum attached to the margins of the acetabulum. Acetabulum is formed by union of three bones. Ilium forms 2/5 part, ischium forms 2/5 part, and pubis forms 1/5 part. It is a primary cartilaginous joint between the three bones, that is ilium, ischium and pubis. Now last part is the obturator foramen. This is a gap between the pubis and ischium and is covered by the obturator membrane. Except at the obturator groove for the passage of obturator vessels and nerve. Inside of the pelvis or inside of the obturator membrane gives origin to obturator internus muscle, and outside gives origin to obturator externus muscle.